There's no such thing as a final frontier in Silicon Valley, and there's a lot of big thinking.
Our friends at NASA have given us clearance to show you the Hover test facility and our lander test vehicle.
Bob Richards wants to mine the moon.
So the focus of the engineering effort at Moon Express is, of course, the lander itself. And this is the prototype.
Moon Express is trying to make money out of landing on the moon. There's $30 million in XPRIZE money to land on the surface, deploy a robot, and send back pictures by 2015. This is where the testing takes place. The vehicle needs to learn how to land itself. There's too much of a delay to control it from Earth, but success can bring great riches.
The most important thing about the moon is probably the stuff we haven't even discovered yet, but what we do know is that there could be more platinum group metals on the surface of the moon than all of the reserves of Earth. We know that there's water on the moon, which is a game changer for the solar system. Water is rocket fuel. It also could support life and agriculture. So exploring the moon commercially is a first step towards making the moon part of our world, what humanity considers our world.
And the race is on. China has been launching moon probes and, knowing the huge potential, wants to land on the moon as well, with robots and astronauts. But can any one person or country own the moon? The 1967 Outer Space Treaty says not.
Well, if we, pun intended, drill down a little bit more into the Outer Space Treaty, we find that whereas appropriation and ownership of the moon is not allowed under the treaty, free access, free use, and free exploitation of the moon is not only encouraged, it's codified, it's in the treaty. And so, well, on the one hand, we have this, you can't own it, but on the other hand, international law says you can go there and you can use it. So how do we balance those two?
There could be a moon rush in the coming decade, and I think there will be as nation states realize the importance of the moon.
This might be a NASA research facility, but these are private companies that are competing to be the next ones onto the surface of the moon. The commercial world is increasingly driving space exploration. It's got to be worth someone's while to help mankind take its next big step. Alastair Leithhead, BBC News, NASA Ames Research Center in California.